Welcome to the MasterCars Pro channel. Today we will talk about the problems and weaknesses of this wonderful car. We're starting with the power units as usual. First generation Mitsubishi Outlander was running on gas only and was aggregated with 2-liter and 2.4-liter non-turbo i4s and turbocharged 2-liter and 2-liter turbo R, all of the 4G6 family. This straight force family appeared in 580s and is well known by servicemen. All the engines are similar in structure and technical issues. Engine lifetime is about 400 to 500,000 km. They have low requirements to fuel quality. Engines, however, need some high quality oil to smoothly operate. Low quality oils lead to hydraulic valve lifter poor functioning on 2.4 motors. Valve lifter lifespan is 50 to 120,000 km, depending on oil quality. Valve lifter malfunction leads to expensive repairs such as valve damage and cylinder head repair or replacement. 2-liter engine is not equipped with hydraulic valve lifters, so valve heat clearance should be adjusted every 80 to 90,000 km, 35 to 45k for cars running on CNG fuels. If it is not done, valve plates will disrupt. Balance shafts can get jammed if there is not enough oil for bearing lubrication, so control oil level. Balance shaft bell also needs periodical replacement. Engine mounts are willing to break, especially left one. Idle RPM can float. Idle RPM regulator, temp sensor, fuel filter, injectors or throttle can be reason to this. Fuel injection system should be cleaned every 50 to 60,000 km. Cylinder head gasket seal can leak some oil, and it becomes possible for oil to reach timing belt, which can be bad. Oil mesh filter is located very close to crankcase housing and can bend after a light kick in the oil pan, so oil pump does not transfer oil to engine moving parts. Auto conditioner pressure sensor power wiring is connected to that of electronic throttle position sensor, so sensor failure makes throttling impossible. Fuel consumption is pretty high, 18 liters per 100 km. Radiator has short lifetime and has been replaced on most cars. Alternator bearing can wear out. All the engines have a timing belt, idle rollers, and the belt itself should be replaced every 80,000 km as well as balance shaft bell. Water pump is driven by timing belt but is extremely durable, so it does not require replacement. Turbocharged Outlanders in used condition are not the best investment, to be honest. Used for aggressive driving, turbo engines can require expensive and long-lasting service and maintenance. Outlanders were aggregated with 5-speed manual and 4-speed auto transmissions. Gearboxes are very rigid and can run over 500,000 km if driven smoothly and maintained properly. Manual gearboxes can require clutch replacement. Early gearboxes may have issues with third gear operation, late ones can have reverse gear issues. Loose can appear in shifter bearings at 200,000 km. It can lead to first and second gear misshifts. Kicks and delays occur in auto transmission work at 150,000 km. Outlander is not a Jeep for heavy off-roading, it is just one of many SUVs, though it has all-wheels drive and huge 195mm lift. All-wheels drive operates through friction clutch with 10% pretension, limiting car off-road abilities. Properly maintained all-wheel drive system operates fine. Small issues occur to drive shaft support bearings, brake at 100,000 km. Frequent off-road driving leads to transfer case replacement at less than 100,000 km. Rear differential mounts are under the risk of early breach. Motion starting then is accompanied with knocks. Suspension is almost undead at any operation conditions. Middle-loaded suspension needs maintenance once in 100,000 km. Front wheel bearings are the weakest component sensitive to wheel hub over tightening and blasting loads. Rubber seals also require some attention. Torsion bar mounts can live for 70,000 km and torsion bar links lifetime is about 100,000 km. Front ball joints and bushings need replacement every 150,000 km. Other elements last for 200,000 km. Rear suspension needs service once in 100,000 km. Lower wishbone's resource rarely is over 50,000 km. Rear suspension bushings can produce squeaks if dirt gets inside. Cars have steering rack and hydraulic power steering. It rarely requires any attention. Leaks can occur in power steering cooling system and high pressure line on used cars. Steering joints' lifespan is limited by 80 to 100,000 kilometers. Brakes, however, are not the strong part of this car. Car is rather heavy, so discs overheat and lose shape. Paint job is pretty soft, so scratches and caverns appear quickly all over the car body. Rear wings and front of the hood are abrasive sensitive. Corrosion resistance is good in common, but aged cars may have some minor issues. Well, if you are the owner of this car, then please describe the problems that you had to face during the operation of the car. Perhaps it is your feedback that will help viewers when choosing a car. That's it for today. Thanks everyone for attention. It isn't much work for you to subscribe to the channel. See you soon.